doing today, man? Happy Sunday. Hey, Miss Renette. Hey, Megan, how y'all doing?
Great.
Huh? Man, listen, we are so excited, man, that we are back in church today, right? Now, again, I know you guys, you know, you're watching us, so you're not, you know, in church. But, hey, we started having church again live in person. So, man, listen, I want to see you guys hopefully next Sunday, right? You know what I'm saying? Whenever you can, man, we are here, 9 o'clock, 11 o'clock Sunday morning. We are having fun praising Jesus, man. Just, hey, I want to see you guys soon. But, hey, listen, today I want to talk to you about something. But, hey, I got Miss Megan and Miss Renette. We're going to play a little game, right? And you know, because school is going to be starting soon, right? I know they pushed the school back. You normally be starting tomorrow, but they pushed it back. I think, what is it?
September
what?
8th.
That's right, the 8th. So, time is running out. So, you see, I have my little game that I'm going to have Miss Megan and Miss Renette playing about kind of like with these little time machine, you know, whatever you call it, thingamajiggies. Say that real fast. Thingamajiggy. So, listen, before we play this game, I want you guys to watch this video while they get prepared for their game, you know, kind of get in the game mode and everything. The video is called This Little Light of Mine. And the reason why I chose that video for today is because we're going to be talking about being a witness for Jesus, man. Going back to school and letting your light shine for Jesus, right? This world needs some light of Jesus. Amen? Come on. Come on. I'm preaching good. I'm preaching better than y'all. I'm just telling you right now. You know what I'm saying? Okay. Anyway, hey, we'll be right back. Check out this video.
This the light of mine, and I'm gonna let it shine. This the light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This the light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Thank you.
Hey, wasn't that a cool video?
Yeah,
man, I like that little video. This little light of mine. Way we used to do it back in the day, man, we'd hold up our finger. You guys do that in the nursery?
Yeah.
This little light of mine. Anyway, hey, man, hope you enjoyed that video. But now it's time to play a game. We're going to call this game the Skittles Shuffle. The Skittles Shuffle. So, you know, time is running out. Your vacation, summertime is almost over. Everybody say, oh, right? I know, man. But hey, listen, I know you're excited because school's starting back up. You can get to see your friends and it's going to be good. It's going to be good. So here's the deal. We have a little game. These ladies have to get all the Skittles that's at the bottom of my little time thingamajiggy. Say it again, thingamajiggy. They're going to have to get it from here to here. Of course, they got to flip it, right? And the first one to get all the Skittles from here to here after they flip it will be the winner. So what you guys think? Miss Megan will be the winner or Miss Renette? Who you think? Who you think? Okay, yeah, I know all you. Okay, I know. I didn't have a guy, man. I need you guy. Anyway, okay, let me stop. Okay, you guys ready?
Sure.
Okay, here we go. You ready? Count down with me. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, go! Come on, there you go. There you go, girl. There you go. And you figured out the trick right there, Miss Raynette. Ah, yeah, Miss Raynette is the winner. I thought Miss Megan, Miss Megan probably seen this game. Miss Megan, what are you doing?
I gotta win somehow.
Did y'all hear me say that they could eat the Skittles? What if I wanted those? No, it's okay. Hey, listen, Miss Raynette, you are the grand prize winner, so we have a Destination Cafe gift card for you, Miss Raynette. Congratulations. Give Miss Raynette a hand clap. She did good. Miss Megan, you get the Skittles. I mean, you already started helping yourself. You know what I'm saying? You get. Matter of fact, Miss Raynette gave you, you can have them all, girl.
Gotta win somehow.
Lord, day. Hey, they both did a good job, man. They made time go fast. So, hey, you know, speaking of making time go fast, listen. We gotta get out of here because time is ticking, and I know you guys are ready to praise the Lord, right? So, man, jump up off the couch, off the table. Good friend, the table. Okay, if you on the table, jump off the table. We don't know what goes on at her house. Hey, we'll be right back. Let's praise the Lord, baby. Come on.
Waking up to another light, no more sorrow and no more night. You're the light, let it shine now, let it shine now. Burning bright, cause we're not ashamed. Got a world to illuminate. You're the light, let it shine now, let it shine now. Yeah.
this place. Take it out, let's get that light shining. Come on, let's fill this room with light. Let's fill this room with light. Woo! Something's changing the atmosphere tonight. Do you believe it? Do you believe it? Come on, we're gonna sing Shine Light together.
Shine a light, shine a light. 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 We got a light and we're gonna shine. Jesus lives and made me glorify. We got a light and we're gonna shine. Forever lives and make me glorify. We got a light and we're gonna shine. Jesus lives and made me glorify. We got a light and we're gonna shine. Forever lives and make me glorify.
Hey, man, welcome back, boys and girls. Listen, I want to share a scripture with you today. The scripture is found in the book of Matthew, chapter 5, verse 16. The Bible says, let your good deeds, in other words, your good works, the things that we do, let them shine out for all to see, right? So that everyone will praise your heavenly Father. See, Jesus wants us to shine out. He wants us, our light to shine. He wants us, our deeds, our works, our actions to shine out. Hey, speaking of shining out, man, I have something with me that you guys might be using this year in school. You might, I use these things still as an adult, man. You say, man, Pastor Marty, what you use those things for? Well, listen, these things are called what? Highlighters, right? So the purpose of a highlighter is when you highlight some words in a book, or like me, sometimes I'll highlight words, you know, things, passages of scripture in my Bible when I'm reading my Bible, so that whenever I come back and I look at the book or I look at my Bible, whatever I'm reading, whatever is highlighted, it stands out, right? It kind of makes it stands out. It makes it different than the rest. Well, that's what God wants for me and you. He wants us to highlight Jesus. He don't want us to highlight ourselves. No, it's not about us, man. It's about us shining our light for Jesus, letting the light of Jesus who is inside of us shine in this world, right? So again, like the Bible says, so that our good deeds will give praise and bring praise to our Heavenly Father so that people will know Jesus, right? Well, watch. Let me show you, because I know you, some of you guys might be saying, well, man, how do I do that, Pastor Martin? Let me share with you three things, three simple things that you can do, not only this year at school, but, man, every day of your life to let the light of Jesus shine through you. In 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 1, the Bible says this. This is the Apostle Paul said. He said, you should imitate me just as I imitate Christ. So how can we let our light shine? We should imitate Christ. What does that mean to imitate Christ? Well, you guys have probably imitated other people, you know, sports characters, actors, cartoons, you know, I don't know. But listen, whenever we imitate somebody, we act like them, right? So how would Jesus act at your school? How would Jesus act in your family? How would Jesus act when he goes to the store, right? So let's be imitators of Jesus. Another thing how we can let our light shine is found in Philippians chapter 4, verse 4. The Bible says here, always be full of joy in the Lord. I say it again, rejoice. You know, another scripture says, today is the day that the Lord has made. I will be glad and rejoice in it. See, it's a choice, man. See, we can choose to be mad and grumpy and complaining all the time, or we can choose to smile and be happy. Let me ask you something. who would you prefer to hang around with at school? Who would you prefer to hang around with in your neighborhood, in your family? People that are grumpy and complaining all the time, or people that are happy and got joy and smiling, right? Well, if you want people to hang around you and people to like you, more so for people to see Jesus, then we should have the joy of the Lord, man. We as Christians should be the most joyful people ever, right? Because our name is written down in the Lamb's Book of Life. We are going to heaven. And then listen, the last scripture I want to share with you today is in Philippians chapter 4, verse 5. The Bible says, let everyone see that you, come on, point to your family, somebody in the room, even your dog, say, you. That's right. The Bible says that let everyone see that you are considerate. Ooh, come on, that's a word right there. Considerate in all that you do. Remember, the Lord is coming soon. See, God wants us to be considerate, man. He don't want us being selfish and thinking about us all the time. We should be considerate. Listen, if you see your teacher needs some help, offer to help her. If you see a boy or girl needing some help with something, offer to help her. If you see your mom or dad, your brother or sister, offer them some help, man. Listen, just be considerate. I'm telling you. People will see you and they say, man, that's a considerate young boy. That's a considerate young girl. That's something different about them. See, they are going to praise our Heavenly Father whenever they see that light shining through you, man. They're going to see something different. And that's when we can say it's because of Jesus in my life. So, hey, I want to close today with praying for you. So, hey, some of you guys saying, man, Pastor Marty, I want to do that. I want my light to shine brighter than ever before. Because right now in this world we're living in, the crazy things going on, we need it more than ever. But the first step, right, the first step is to invite Jesus into your heart to be your Lord and Savior. So, hey, would you pray with me? Pray loud enough with your mouth that you can hear it with your own ears, okay? Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, Lord, we come to you today in the name of Jesus to say thank you for loving me so much that you gave your son Jesus to die on the cross to pay the price for my sins and the sins of the world. And I believe today that you are alive, you're well, you're in heaven. And God, I believe that as I invite you to come into my heart, you will do so. Be inside me, and you will be the light of my life, and I will be the light of the world because of you inside me. Help me this year at school. Help me this year in my neighborhood, in my family, everywhere I go, to shine the light of Jesus so that people will see you and glorify you and live for you. And it's in Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. Hey, man, listen, again, we are having church live in person. Two services on Sunday morning, 9 o'clock, 11 o'clock. I want to see you in person. So please come by. Let me know that you watch me here online, man. And I'll give you a high five, air high five, something, you know, something, we'll elbow bump, something, you know, all right? Hey, I'll see you guys soon. Bye-bye.